If you need a portfolio, a blog, or even a full-blown e-commerce store, look no further than Hostinger Website Builder and this tutorial. So I've been messing around with Hostinger Builder recently and just decided to put it to the test in this video. I'm gonna build a complete site, I'm gonna walk through some of the useful tips, and give my honest opinion on the overall experience with Hostinger's tools. All right, so for this Hostinger tutorial, I'll create a portfolio, but the process for other types of websites is similar. Well, maybe an e-commerce site is a little bit different, so I'm gonna show you how to set up an online store as well. All right, so starting with the portfolio though, I could transfer a website from another provider, but I wanna show you how it's done from the very beginning. I wanted a sleek, professional portfolio site, and I wanted to build it quickly. For that reason, I turned to Hostinger's AI website builder. So I've tried other AI site builders before, but to be honest, Hostinger's experience just felt like the smoothest and fastest to get started with. The pricing was another W for Hostinger, for me rather. If you don't have Hostinger yet, you can get it with my discount by scanning this QR code or clicking the link in the description. Okay, let's get this Hostinger website builder tutorial rolling. After using my Hostinger login, I headed to the Websites tab to the left and just started a new project by selecting the builder. Right away, Hostinger's AI prompt appeared ready to guide the process. So it was super easy to start. Just add the brand name or website title, describe the type of website that you want, and the AI just creates it for you. I typed a simple but to the point prompt for my portfolio that probably didn't even take a minute, and a full website template was built. It is actually really polished and surprisingly on brand. The site was already populated with demo images and text ready to be replaced. If you don't like the style of the site that got built, you can just try again. For me, even the first go was good for this time. I just wanted a different color scheme. The green will give my portfolio more life, I think. All right, so the created site gave me a great start on what I needed, a striking hero section with background imagery and a bold intro, a gallery for headshots and production stills, a spot for my acting reel, a clean biography section, and a simple contact form. From there, I jumped into the editor to personalize everything. First, I added a YouTube video for my channel. It's really simple to do. On the left side menu, select Add Elements, and there you're gonna see the video option. Clicking on that is gonna drop a video into your website, which you can move wherever you want by simply dragging it. You can also resize it and add animation, and of course, a link to the video if you want. Just keep in mind that mostly only YouTube and Vimeo are accepted. Some other video platforms might work too, but it's not a guarantee. With images and photos, it's really similar as well. So instead of a URL, you just upload it from your device. I also added some stock images from their built-in library, and I even played with the AI image generator to create a dramatic theater-themed background. Just keep in mind that those have limited credits, so if you run out, you'll need to restock. Overall though, I really appreciate such a simple drag-and-drop editor. It felt intuitive, easy to use, and didn't mess up the layout when I moved things around. Another tool I found especially useful was the AI logo maker. I didn't have a logo already, but the tool let me generate a sleek signature style logo in just a couple of minutes. And it might not yet be on the level of a professional designer, but it's far better looking than what I could come up with in Photoshop, and much quicker as well. So the mobile view editor was another highlight. It let me make sure that the site looked great on phone, which is essential when casting directors or agents are checking out your work on the go. So don't forget to make sure your site looks good and functions well on mobiles as well. Okay, so there are a few tools that I didn't end up using that much. All right, the blog feature is cool if you want to write updates or behind the scenes content, but it wasn't necessary for this particular project. And as far as the e-commerce functionality goes, I'll cover that in a second. After over an hour of editing and tweaking, my site was done. So let's hit the preview and see the results. So I have to say, I think it feels cinematic and professional. The homepage features a full screen headshot and a simple tagline. Right beneath that, I embedded a video reel so visitors could see me in action right away. The gallery section showcased stills from previous roles. The bio told my story in a polished but personal tone, and the contact form made it easy for anyone to get in touch or download my resume. So I can hit publish to go live. It prompts me to set up a domain. Hostinger gives it for free for the first year, but be mindful about pricing after the freebie expires. Alternatively, you can go with a subdomain for now and deal with the domain later. Honestly, if you've been thinking about building a personal website but keep putting it off because you think it's too technical or time-consuming, this is your sign to go for it, okay? Hostinger's AI website builder made the whole process just incredibly easy and enjoyable. All right, now, as promised, for a complete how to use Hostinger website builder guide, you also want to know how to add online stores to your website, so I'll show you how simple that is. From the left-hand menu, I just clicked add store and then immediately pulled up the e-commerce tools. Hostinger automatically added a shop page to my site, along with the backend dashboard for managing products, orders, payments, and all that good stuff. So from there, I started building the store directly into my portfolio layout. The AI-generated design still looked clean and professional, and the store just became another section of the site. So I renamed it and placed it in the site navigation so it was easy to find. I uploaded product photos, wrote up a short, compelling set of descriptions and set the pricing. Hostinger's editors let me tweak how the products were displayed, grid, you know, versus list featured items, and even filtered options for customers. And all of this still matched the original design of the portfolio site. Now, other tools like the blog feature or appointment booking, I didn't really touch this for this project. I mean, they're cool to have, but since the goal was just get products in front of people and make sales, I just kept things streamlined. So after adding a secure payment method, which was built into the builder, no plugins were needed, and the store was ready to go. The final result looked like it had always been part of my website. From my portfolio to a slick product page, everything felt connected, seamless, and just totally custom. So if you're already using Hostinger's website builder and thinking about selling something, your own merch, a friend's product, anything really, you don't need to start from scratch. You can build on what you already have and launch an online store in minutes. By the way, I'm reminding you that I do have a Hostinger coupon code for the best price in the description. It works with the business plan as well, which is needed for e-commerce functionality that I've just put on display. All right, so I built a professional portfolio and an online store in one, and that didn't even take an afternoon. Overall, my experience with Hostinger's website builder was really impressive. The AI tools saved me a ton of time, and the intuitive drag and drop controls made the whole process just incredibly smooth. Whether you're just getting started or looking for a hassle-free way to build a professional site, I'd wholeheartedly recommend giving Hostinger website hosting and builder a try. If you have already, leave a comment down below with your experience. And if you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to give it a like and a subscribe for more content. Okay, that's all for this Hostinger web builder review. See you next time. Bye.